right, so we're going to talk about body positioning on the bike, and we're going to talk about posture. Just like we talk about posture in a deadlift, we talk about posture in running. But what about posture on the bike? How do you place your body on the bike, and how do you move in concert with the bike? You'll see a lot of cyclists that create unnecessary energy expenditure because their posture isn't properly aligned while they're sitting on the bike or while they're standing and they're pedaling. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to just drive by and show you how to properly lift your body off of the bike. Remember, for those of you that, if you're back east and it's cold outside and you don't get the beautiful weather we do here in Southern California, you're probably going to be training indoors. There's a difference between training indoors on the bike and actually getting on your bike and riding it down the road. And the big difference is if you're on a trainer at home or on an indoor bike inside, you're going to have to mimic the road. The bike doesn't move inside. You've got to move a little bit on the bike inside. When we go outside, the bike is going to move, but the body is going to remain in good posture and maintain integrity the whole time. So what you're going to see right now is I'm going to show you the first little rollout that we do is I'm going to show you improper form with excessive body movement. Then I'm going to quiet it down. I'm going to stand up and show you how my toes, my knees, the greater trochanter of my hip, my deltoid, everything stays nice in alignment right over general center, but the bike will be moving underneath me. All right, here we go. So what we're gonna start with first is just real simple on the road seated. So as soon as I stand, you'll see a lot of cyclists make excessive body movement. You're seeing my posture break. So now as soon as I smooth this out, the bike now starts to move and I'm a lot more fluid. The body remains still the whole time. Again, excessive movement with the body, not efficient. Quiet it down, smooth it out, more powerful position to drive into the pedals and create a lot of speed. All right, so we talked about body movement on the bike. What about pedal alignment? Where do your legs go over the pedals when you pedal? So you'll see some experienced riders, it looks like their knees are actually shooting out at about 11 o'clock or 1 o'clock. The proper way to pedal, I almost want you to think about you're hammering a nail into the ground. So the most powerful phase in the pedal stroke is kind of a preload phase around 1 o'clock. Right around 3 to 4 o'clock in that pedal stroke, the most power is being put down. So what I'm going to show you now as we roll out, I'm going to show you proper alignment of your leg. It's called Q factor, right out of your hip through your femur. What we want to do is create a nice straight line in line with that crank arm and the pedal. We don't want to have any transference of energy away from our center. So we're trying to go straight up and down, creating a nice circular movement. And what you're going to see, a lot of cyclists are very lateral dominant. We want to have equal, very symmetrical between VMO, all parts of your quad. You're going to see that fire together. So again, like we did with posture, I'm going to show you improper pedal technique straight on, then I'm going to smooth it out, go straight ahead so you can see how much more fluid you become when you pedal. All right, here we go. So again, as we start, you're going to see a lot of cyclists, once they engage, pedals, feet are going to go out, knees are going to shoot out, or you may see knees almost going over the top two. So what we're going to look at is smoothing it out. So if this is improper, or I'm tracking here, now I smooth it out, knees right over those pedals, smooth, and look how the body starts to smooth out. So now, once I smooth that out and I change gears, much easier to accelerate, much cleaner, and off we go. All